Hi there, welcome to my channel English Byte. Today, I'm going to teach you one of the competencies in junior high school. It is about the use of could, should, and would. But before that, if you're new in this channel, please don't forget to like, subscribe, click the notification bell in order to be updated, and of course, please share also. The topics that I usually handle in my class as grade 9, English 9 and English 10 teacher. By the way, this is one of the competencies in junior high school subjects. Okay, could, should, and would are words that belong to modal verbs. And when we say modal verbs, they are auxiliary or helping verbs that express necessity, ability, or possibility. Now, kailan ba natin gagamitin ang could? Number one, could is used in imaginary situations or possibility. Example, I could play chess without practice. This is only an imagination or possibility. If you're going to translate this in Filipino, kaya kong maglaro ng chess nang walang ensayo. Another one, we could reach the summit before sunset. By the way, if we are going to analyze the structure in the sentence begins with the subject I, and then followed with our modal verb could, and then followed with the main verb play without. This is actually a root word. There is no ed, there is no ing, so this is not a participle. This is a root word. Now, another one is, we could reach the summit before sunset. Our subject is we, followed with the modal verb could, and then followed with the root word reach. With, again, this is not a participle. There is no ending in ing or ed. Wala. Now, as I've said, this is used in situations or possibility. Kaya kung maaari nating marating ang tuktok bago lumumog ang araw. It is only a possibility. Next, could is also used in expressing past ability. Yung kakayahan na ginagawa sa nakaraan o nakalipas. Example, my friend could sing like a pro by the age of 12. Notice here, the use of could is in the past ability, yung kakayahan sa nakalipas na panahon. In Filipino, ang aking kaibigan ay kayang umawit na parang professional sa edad na 12. Next, number 3. It is also used in making suggestions. Example, you could go out and relax for a while. Pwede ka lumabas at mag-relax. Masandali. Next is, in making requests. Example, could I borrow your car for a while? Hindi ka pwedeng gumamit dito ng would. Or would I borrow your car for a while? Or should I borrow your car for a while? This is a request, kaya ang gamit natin dito ay could. Next, could is also used in conditionals. Example, we could have started on our project if I were free today. Yung conditional natin dito ay itong word na if I were free. Itong project ay hindi kasama rito sa conditionals. Now, our main sentence is we could have started on our project. Ito ang ating independent clause. By the way, itong ating if I were free today, this is a dependent or subordinate clause. It does not make any meaning or sense if you are not going to include that, add that in the independent clause. Itong we could have started on our project. So, kaya siya naging conditional kasi itong dependent clause ay nag-uumpisa dito sa word na if. Sa Tagalog, kung. Next, I could lend you money if you promise to pay in time. There's another conditional. Ang conditional natin ay dito sa nag-uumpisa sa word na if. If you promise to pay on time. And then ang ating independent clause ay, I could lend you money. Again, ito ay conditional kasi may word na if. Sa Tagalog ay kung. Pahihiraman kita ng pera kung mangangako ka na magbabayad ka sa tamang oras. Next, now would is used in imaginary situations. Ang would daw ay ginagamit sa mga bagay na ini-imagine lang o sa isip lang. Say for example, I thought I would be late, so I hail a taxi. Ito ay sa isip lang niya, pero hindi naman yung totoo. So, dito, akala ko, mauhuli na ako, kaya pumara ako ng taxi. Next, if I could, I would. Now, this dialogue is the famous dialogue of Moses in the film Ten Commandments. Sabi niya, if I could, I would. Kung kaya ko, gagawin ko. So, this one, dito, madi-differentiate natin ang meaning ng could. Ang could dito sa Filipino ay kaya, ang would naman ay gagawin. Okay, ito yon. Could sa Filipino kaya, would ay gagawin. Pero, ito ay nababago rin pagka iba naman ang sentence. Kasi it always depends on situation. You know, English is unlike math. Where in math, there is always one exact answer. But in English, it is case-to-case basis. Next, when to use should? Number one, should is used in expressing probability. Like this one. The guests should be arriving any moments now. Ang mga bisita ay maaaring dumating anumang sandali ngayon. Another one, he should be bringing a gift for you. Siya ay dapat na magdala ng regalo para sa iyo. So dito, dapat siya. O kung tatalasin natin dapat dito sa ano, ang mga guests, ang mga bisita ay dapat na darating na anumang sandali ngayon. So should dito ay dapat. Pero kung minsan ito, nagiging maaaring eh. Maaari, katulad dito, ang mga bisita ay maaaring dumating anumang sandali ngayon. Pwede ring dapat. Ang mga bisita ay dapat na dumating pero parang awkward ang dapat. So, maaaring dito. Next, in asking questions like this one, should we ask for a fee? Ito ay tanong. Remember, if the sentence is in a question form like this, dapat mauuna ang should. And then followed with the subject, and then followed with the main verb, itong ask. Yan ang format kapag question ang ating ginagawa. Mauna ang subject, mauna ang modal na should, followed with the subject, tapos kasunod ang root word, the verb. Next, should is also used in expressing obligation. Like this one, you should pay for your rent. Ikaw ay dapat na magbayad ng iyong renta o upa. Next, in expressing opinion, like this one, you should behave in front of our teacher. Ikaw ay dapat na maging magpakita ng tamang ugali sa harap ng ating guro. Next, you should stop eating junk food. Ikaw ay dapat na huminto na sa pagkain ng junk food. Next. Now, when to use would? Continuation ito. Number one is in expressing polite request. Kapag tayo ay sasabi ng magalang na request. Example, I would like to order fried chicken. Now notice, ang would dito ay may kasunod na like. Kasi kapag ka hindi mo yan ilagay ng like, siya for example, I would order fried chicken. Parang siya ay command. hindi siya mag hindi siya magandang pakinggan kasi parang walang galang. Pero pag lagyan mo ng like, I would like to order fried chicken, it sounds respectful. Next, impolite offers like this one. Would you like coffee? Okay. Hindi ka pwedeng gumamit dito ng should. Should you like coffee? O kaya, could you like coffee? Hindi pwede. Wait long, would lang ang pwede rito sa polite offers. Next, in converting direct to reported speech. Now, this is another competency in grade 9 and grade 10 English. Itong pagko-convert from direct speech to reported speech. So direct speech, it will be cloudy today, said Justin. Pag dito, will ang ginamit. Pag ito ay ginawang direct speech, magiging ganito na. So, I mean, pag reported speech na, ang will ay magiging would. Justin said that it would be cloudy today. Yan ang isang gamit ng would. Next, in conditional, in imaginary situation, conditional in imaginary situations, like this one. If I were you, I would pay attention to what our teacher is saying. Kung ako ikaw, I would pay attention to what our teacher is saying. Bibigyan ko ng pansin kung ano ang sinasabi ng ating guro. So, dito, conditional ito kasi meron siyang if dito sa ating dependent clause. Ang dependent clause ay nauna rito. If I were you, I would pay attention to what our teacher is saying. Now, notice here, pagkatapos ng dependent clause, may comma, space, and then kasunod ay yung independent clause. Pag inuna natin ang independent clause, like this one, I would pay attention to what our teacher is saying if I were you. Hindi na tayo gagamit ng comma. Next, in habitual action in the past. Say, for example, I had a friend from Baguio, which is about 20 kilometers away, and we would meet every Sunday morning, and we would jog along Bonham Park. Now, notice here that the use of would. Kasi itong sentence is about habitual action in the past. Yung palaging ginagawa sa nakalipas na panahon. Okay, so gagamit tayo dito ng would, like this one. We would meet, and then we would jog. Now, if you've learned something in this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, click the notification bell in order to be updated, and of course, please share also. Thank you very much for watching.